Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to another video. Today we're gonna learn how to create a very nice curtain material. Again, this is a video for Octane beginners, so we're not gonna go deeper on any of the procedurals or materials that Octane has, okay? So let's get started. Okay guys, so I'm gonna show you how I got this result. So to do that, I'm gonna unplug everything and here, here, and here. So again, for those who watched my last video talking about the fabric material, probably we're going to remember that I used a falloff map to create a fabric filling to the material. So this is very important, and for any kind of material that represent any kind of fabric or tissue, I use a falloff applied to it, to this material. Okay, so okay, the next point is I think it's, for me, is better because Octane doesn't have a preview shader. So for me, it's important to see the effect of this falloff happening in real time on my render. So sometimes it's better use an RGB. So let me use an RGB here. And I will plug it here and put a red color and plug the albedo here. So here we go. So like this, I can see much clearer what's the effect that my falloff are having on my material. So here I can control if I need and give more value to some areas and less value to other areas. Okay, so this is a very important trick that I recommend you guys to do. It's not just like create a falloff and apply to it. You have like to control it, and the best way to do that is apply an RGB. Sometimes is even better if you apply like two RGBs, one like red and one blue, and you can see much better the effect you are having. Okay, once you have the effect based on your reference, then it's time to apply the bitmaps you have to this mixed texture. Okay. And in most of the case, I use falloff combined with a mix texture. And the reason is I use it is, actually you have just seen it, I can use textures applied to this mix texture here, and I can see much better the results, okay? Okay, so the texture I'm using, I got it from 3D, no, not 3D Sky, of course not. I got it from textures.com. Okay, so it's this texture over here. I'm using this guy, that is the texture applied to the BAMP. So here, let me unplug this. So here you can see the BAMP effect. And also, I apply the color, this bitmap here, that is this color correction on the transmission to have some kind of translucence on this material. But this is not enough for a curtain. Okay, what you have to do is apply and fall off on the opacity. So this is where we got the curtain effect, and you can control like how much This material you have when we are talking about opacity. So plug it on the opacity, and then here on the minimum value you can control the effect of this fabric. Okay, so of this tissue or any kind of fabric you are planning to have as a curtain. Okay, so as you can see here, as less value I have here, more opacity I have, more translucent it is. So you can control it playing around with the minimum value. Okay, so basically that's it, guys. It's very simple to do, like any curtain material. I really encourage you guys to try to do that and apply it on a scene, use it on a scene, and send it to me to see the effect that you got. Okay, yeah, I think that's it. Thank you, guys. Thanks a lot. And if you have any questions, please let me know. I'll be glad to answer. And yeah, that's it. Thank you very much, and see you in the next video.